Fruits and vegetables account for nearly 90% of the total horticulture production in the country. Horticulture as a sector has performed remarkably well, with production of fruits and vegetables outstripping that of food grains for the third consecutive year. In 2014-2015, the country's horticulture production stood at 281 million tons compared to 251 million tons of food grains production. India is now the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world and is the leader in several horticultural crops, namely mango, banana, papaya, cashew nut, areca nut, potato, and okra. Today, the horticulture sector accounts for 30% of the total agricultural output. While this sector is doing the country proud, there are major concerns in terms of post-harvest loss. The cumulative loss is very high and ranges between 5 and 20% of the production. The annual value of harvest and post-harvest losses of major agricultural products at the national level is estimated to the tune of 92,651 crore rupees. The primary reason for these post-harvest losses is inadequate infrastructure, absence of modern food supply chain, and fragmentation of farms. The issue of post-harvest losses can be dealt with to a certain extent by replicating Amul's cooperative model. Take the case of Sahyadri Farmers Producer Company, founded by Vilas Shinde. The idea of Shinde was to ensure a fair return to the farmers and the consumers get quality grapes. Located 170 kilometers northeast of Mumbai, 600 meters above sea level, is Nashik, where large areas of vineyards surround the city. Sahyadri Farms have an affiliation with 1,000 grape growers in this region. By providing end-to-end solutions to farmers, it has changed the entire landscape. Right from guiding the farmers how to cultivate crops, which seeds to use, how to pack their produce, and which countries in Europe they can export to, Sahyadri Farmers is guiding them.
Basically, we started our career with grape farming. 20 years back, when I passed out from agriculture university as an agriculture graduate, and when I started agriculture as a profession, what we're learning in the last 10 years, that individual farming is not beneficial for farmers. Because there are a lot of challenges which individual farmers cannot handle that challenges. So they need to come together and make a system which will be helpful to the farmers at different levels, whether to handle on back-end side challenges or front-end challenges. So that's why we started this Sahyadri Farmers Producer Company, which is based on a cooperative model, you can say mainly Amul model.
In the beginning, even Sahyadri farmers were facing post-harvest losses due to improper cooling, as it took 8 to 10 hours for cooling. These long cooling hours led to weight losses, while at the same time deteriorated the quality of the produce. To overcome this issue, it invested in Danfoss equipments, which reduced not only the cooling time, but also reduced energy consumption.
The Sahyadri is an extremely good example of what has happened in Amul or in the milk industry, where cooperative farmers came together. It's a great example of how you can do it in the fruits and vegetables. So when we started working with Sahyadri Farms, we found out that the farmers decided to come together and set up their own cold storage. Our intention here was to make sure that, remember that every time a product hits a cold storage, there is a cost that is getting added to it. So our intention was to make it the lowest cost, because you spend some amount of money onto it. How can we reduce it? By ensuring proper pre-cooling is properly done, ensuring that variable frequency drives are set into it. By bringing down the refrigeration costs that are there, or the cold chain costs that are there, we have helped farmers benefit from the amount of money that they can make. So if, when they add on to it, any amount of saving that we can bring in the energy costs is a savings for the farmer.
Undoubtedly, Danfoss equipment has brought down energy costs for the Sahyadri farms, as cooling now takes around 3 to 4 hours compared to 8 to 10 hours before. These equipments have also helped farmers to get better quality of grapes, transforming to better sales as the produce is sold at higher rates. Farmers now fetch 20% higher prices for their produce.
We are associated with Danfoss from last 3 years. Normally we said that 30% is wastaging fruit and vegetables. Mm-hmm. But in our system, you'll find that it is not more than 5%. So almost 25% saving we are doing because of these systems.
Certainly, these cooling solutions have made Sahyadri Farms a successful model. This cooperative movement, which started in 2004 with 10 farmers exporting 10 containers of grapes, has now grown into 1,000 farmers exporting over 625 containers every year. It is clear that the cooperative model of Sahyadri Farms is the way forward for the horticulture sector. It needs to be replicated across the country.